is it?
Yes, yeah, sure.
It's almost time for our news bulletin.
European soldiers in the Middle East could be in danger after 3 days challenged Iran over breaching its nuclear deal. Hassan Rouhani made the threat in a televised speech. Tensions remain high between Tehran and Washington over President Donald Trump withdrawing the U.S. from the deal in 2018. In his speech, Mr. Rouhani criticized Britain, France, and Germany for starting the dispute process. He and 2,000 others had the chance to extend their lives. Government's drug buying agency Pharmac has reached a provisional deal to fund the life-extending breast cancer drug Ibrance. Jordan Bond reports.
7 years ago, Sarah Nicholson was told she had a year to live with stage 4 breast cancer that's now spread to her bones. She says medical advances every year, but more now drugs that can slow the progress of some cancers. And she's hopeful one day soon they can be stopped.
So every day we're alive, we're getting closer to a cure or a manageable disease, so
I'm very optimistic.
50,000 people signed a petition urging Pharmac to fund Ibrance. Pharmac chief executive Sarah Cook says the deal is a direct result of the government's $60 million funding boost in September last year.
I mean, it's a big commitment, a budget, so we need to be make sure that we're making the right decision, because if we fund this medicine, we don't fund another medicine, so we have to be sure that we're making the right call.
It's not a done deal yet.
It's a consultation period first, but with a high chance.
The drug will be available in April. Call Jordan Watch, I hope.
Parts of central Wellington will remain in standstill for months while the sewers are fixed. And the authorities admit they still don't know how to fix part of the problem. A lot occurred in one of Wellington's main sewer pipes just before Christmas, sending millions of litres of sewage spilling into the harbour. Sections of key city streets remain closed to traffic while temporary piping is in place. Wellington Water's Ian McSherry says just surveying and developing a tunnel to the collapsed pipe will take months.
22 metres deep off the top end, dealing with things that are not yet, you know, is complex, so we want just to take the time to do proper risk analysis and have a proper robust plan before we go in and start doing any physical construction works.
Wellington Water's Ian McSherry. A new television series for Lord of the Rings is causing some headaches for local film producers as they struggle to find workers and stores. Amazon's $1 billion series is set to kick off next month. The chief executive of Great Southern Television, Steve Scott, says while filming is a boon, it is causing some headaches.
It's quite a good problem to have, like having an industry in New Zealand that's so incredibly experienced and exciting. No one's going to be complaining about that. But clearly there's only a certain number of people who can do an exceptional job, and when international companies come in, they want the very best in the world. And so a huge market has emerged in the market of the real want to be the best people.
Says the local film industry is also struggling to find studio space. The New Zealand stock market has closed at a record high. The NZX Top 50 Index rose by 52 points, just under half of a percentage point, to a record 11,677. International sentiment is being driven by the signing of a preliminary trade deal between the US and China. New Zealand's share market rose more than 30% last year, making it one of the best performing in the developed world. Police have confirmed the victim at the centre of a homicide investigation in Southampton is a female. Investigators have been at the property on Caulfield Close conducting a scene investigation, which will continue tomorrow. Acting Detective Inspector Sean Nicholas says detectives are working hard to establish what has occurred. So police are also investigating another incident of Caulfield Close that occurred in December 2019. So it's planned to stay at the eventual news. Six of the leading U.S. Democratic candidates for their party's presidential nomination have taken part in a televised debate in Iowa. Each tried to convince the public they were the candidate best positioned and able to beat Donald Trump in the November election. Foreign affairs featured large in the debate, and gender was another main issue. The BBC's Anthony Zirkle was there.
A lot of people at the beginning of this debate were watching to see if there was going to be a clash between Bernie Sanders and Elizabeth Warren, two most liberal candidates in this race. The conversation they had back in 2018 where Bernie Sanders allegedly told us Elizabeth Warren, that a woman from the political presidency will not came up in the debate. Elizabeth Warren and Bernie Sanders disagreed again. It's interesting what Elizabeth Warren did from there. She pivoted to talk about how well the two women on the stage, her and Amy Klobuchar, had done in running their own campaigns and winning elections. Met on the stage.
And a new just ahead, the National State for Workplace Incident and Current Jewish this evening. The police were called to distribution made in Stockholm at about 20:06. Work safe at the police and investigating. The death has been referred to the coroner. The newly appointed chair of the Hawke's Bay DHB says board members were not made aware of a letter telling hundreds of elderly their health was sure would be cut before it was sent. Shane Walker says he's glad the district health for alternatives has since apologised and reinstated 605 people.
One day team of the year. This has been strange.
The top seed is out of the AFC Classic Tennis Tournament. Italian Fabio Fognini, the world's number 12, lost in 3 sets to Spain's Feliciano Lopez in their second round match in Auckland today. Earlier in the day, Lopez, who's 38, spent almost 2.5 hours in court and winning his first round match. Second seed, Denis Shapovalov, had a straight set win tonight over fellow Canadian Russian Kasparov. Martin Kovac and Marcus Daniel will be seen in place for both in the bubbles. Michael Venus and Australian partner John Pears, 7676. That's the news.
Everyone has
a